We are here with SteelSeries Chief Gaming Officer, and we are going to be talking about the Flux In-Ear and the Flux In-Ear Pro. We're going to start with the Pro, though.
Welcome to Linus Tech Tips at CES 2013. Our trip to the show this year is powered by Corsair, maker of quality PC components and peripherals. Our trusted storage partner is Seagate Technology, and our trusted networking partner is Linksys.
So, I don't know if you guys are familiar with SteelSeries, but they make a couple of, you know, peripherals and audio products, and basically, you know, if you have a chief gaming officer on your staff, then I'd say you're sort of a gaming-oriented company. What makes these optimal for gamers or for, let's say, not gamers?
It's a balanced amateur headset, which means that it's practically distortion-free. It has a really, really clear soundscape. For a first-person shooter where you want to have like spatial sound and awareness, that's super, super good. What makes them very unique also is that during our development of these, when we tried to sort of like make a really good product, we realized one thing, which was that all in-ears are really designed to look pretty.
Here's an example.
Yeah.
These look really pretty. They don't sound great. And check out the way that this is ripped out of here.
And we found that in all our testing, actually, that they look very, very pretty. They're not necessarily like really nice and comfortable. We bought more than 100 different in-ears. We tested them, and we couldn't find a sort of a favorite internally, which was like an eye-opener. So we actually started looking at hearing aids instead. A hearing aid is a medical device that's designed to be in your ear and be comfortable all day.
Right.
So we designed these after hearing aids, where you just put them in, and you can feel immediately when they plug in and when they're comfortable. And that's something you can wear for hours and hours.
And it's true, you guys. You actually can. Diesel wears. Diesel wears earbuds that do go over and around his ear, and I always kind of thought that was a little bit weird. I'd never actually tried it before. It feels a little weird at first, but you were saying that you actually use this
for running
now.
Yeah.
Okay.
Another thing that's cool, they come with an 8-pin connector system here. So for a PC, it comes with two dual plugs, and for an iPhone or a tablet or a Mac, it comes with this. It's very easy to use.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah. That's something we will be touching a lot more in the future.
Okay, so here, should we do like a non-tangle sort of demo here?
You can do that.
Sure. Okay, so I'm going to put it in my pocket. Now, I've seen a fair number of non-tangle cords. I've even seen braided non-tangle cords that are just around. Come on, it doesn't work. You need a ribbon cable if you want to have a non-tangle design. So you take this out of your ear, you take it out of your pocket, it's going to look like this. They're actually using a slightly wider ribbon cable that is a little bit thicker as well than even ribbon non-tangle cables that I've seen in the past. This, I believe, is what helps to contribute to making it even more non-tangle than what you would normally see, which is sort of, I mean, even this isn't non-tangle at all. So yeah, there you go. So tell us about the pricing of the Flux In-Ear Pro, and what's it competing against?
I think it's competing against any balanced amateur headset. The price would be $129, which is incredibly aggressively priced. I think it's the best sounding headset under $200.
Okay. So there you go, guys. As you know, I recommend nothing but SteelSeries 7Hs to anyone who asks me about what headset to buy for gaming, what headset to buy for their computer, basically. I think it's the best sounding headphone under $150, $180, hands down. So if they've done the same thing with the Flux In-Ear Pro, that's great. I actually haven't tested it yet, but I've brought Slick, who is more of our golden ear guy, to tell us what he thinks about it.
First, to go over ergonomics and design and all that kind of stuff, I usually do not like in-ear headphones because they just don't fit in my ears properly. But these ones, when it went around, you could really, really tell that they were designed to fit properly in your ears.
You know what's my favorite thing? These ones, I keep bringing up these, I don't really like them. But look how far they stick out of your ear and how weighted they are towards the outer. So what happens is anytime there's any pressure on them, it pulls them out and there's that weight on your ear canal. So anyway, go ahead, audio quality.
I can't listen to music while running because my headphones always fall out. So that's actually fantastic. Audio quality was great. A lot of times with gaming stuff, you find that they just pound bass for no absolute reason. And you'll play something that's like a classical song, but all you hear is brrr. These had a really, really wide range, but were still able to pound bass. So that was really nice to hear.
All right. So tell us about the more entry-level product. This is the Flux In-Ear.
Yeah. So these are designed differently.
Did we lose our Flux In-Ear? There we go.
So these are designed a little bit differently. They're based on a different
type
of driver.
Come in nice and close and have a look.
And they're designed to fit into your ear. They could actually basically go further into your ear. It is not as distortion-free as the balanced amateur. Obviously, there's also a technology difference. But I would also go on record and say that for $59, that's the best sound. $49, that's the best sounding headset you'll get, period.
And then because, again, you guys are sort of gaming-oriented company, it comes with those dual adapters as well, right?
No, not this one.
This is
only for mobile.
Only for mobile, but it does have a mic,
yes.
So you can use it as a headset.
Yes.
No problem. Something to be aware of, guys, is you can actually buy adapters from your dual sockets to these. I think you can get them at a lot of dollar stores, so I wouldn't worry too much about not having that one included. However, I am really excited to try the In-Ear Pro. I was busy shooting a video about the keyboard, and am I missing out?
Yes.
Yeah, okay, I'm getting the yes, I'm missing out. Thank you very much for doing this little interview, and guys, I'm very excited to see more in-ear products. I do like the way they sound. I like the fact that you don't have to wear a big thing. And I love SteelSeries audio products, so there you go. Good work.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thanks for watching Linus Tech Tips at CES 2013, powered by Corsair, Seagate Technology, and Linksys.